So I'm going to share with you the Dirty Dozen workout that I did at the last hotel I was at. They didn't have any kettlebells for the first exercise I'm going to do, but I just used a dumbbell. They were a little bit awkward of dumbbells that they had, so if you have one of these ones, like the ones that aren't huge, then you'll be all set. But I'll show you it both ways with a kettlebell and with the dumbbell. So the first exercise was a figure eight squat with a jump in and out. So you're going to start with those legs wide. You're going to squat down, go under both legs, hold it here, jump in, out. Go down, hold it here, in, out. Okay, so that one is 12 reps. They're all 12 reps. 12 exercises, 12 reps each with the dumbbell. You just hold it here, go underneath, come here, in, out. Go under, hold it, in, out. So that was the first exercise. Second one, you are going to squat, press, tricep extension, down, tricep, and down. Squat and press, tricep extension, and down. Now if you don't have lighter dumbbells, or you don't want to use two, because you find doing this, it's too hard, your elbows aren't staying in. You can grab the dumbbell like this. Instead of using two lighter ones, grab one. It's a little bit heavier. Squat, press, tricep extension. Okay, so there's that one. That's 12 reps. Next one. You don't need anything. Walking, burpee, with a knee drive. So you're gonna bring your hands down to the ground, walk one foot back, other one, step your foot in, and jump up. So whichever knee is coming up, that foot goes back first, in and up. So that's one, and that's two. Okay, so obviously if you don't wanna jump up, you can just drive that knee up. Next one. Heavy dumbbell, unless your shoulders are weak. You're going to be on one leg. You're going to kind of do a little one-legged squat, come up and pull. One-legged squat, come up and pull. Squat, reach to your foot, and pull. Okay, so it's on one leg. Obviously, you can put that foot back a bit. Just go on your toe. You have a little balance issue. Down and row. Alright, so there's that one. It's going to be 12 each side. Next one. Walk out to a push-up. So, legs straight, walk yourself out. Push-up. Walk yourself back. Stand up though. Come down. Walk out. Push-up. Walk back. And stand. Alright, so 12 reps of that. Next one I'm going to use my mat for, because I don't have, this one doesn't have the ridges around it. So, renegade row, keeping those hips down to the ground. Feet in, holding a low squat. Row, that's one rep. And that's two. So if you don't want to jump your feet back, obviously, right, you can just walk your feet. All right, next one. A little bit of cardio in here, a little bit of strength. Just kind of doing, I call it a stutter lunge. Okay, 12 per side on that one. All right, back to the dumbbells. So, you're going to do curtsy lunge. Come center and curl. That's one rep. Curtsy, squat center, curl. That's two. That's three. So pretty much you're counting the squats there for the 12 reps, squats and the biceps. If you wanted, you could count the curtsy lunges, but then you're gonna have to do 12 per side. And that's gonna take a little bit longer, so you won't be able to get through all 12 exercises as fast as you would if you're just counting the squats and the curls. Next one, another cardio one. Mat behind you. You're gonna squat down, roll back, come up, and jump up. Roll back, jump up. Obviously, you can use your hands to help you get up a little bit. So this one is one of my favorite ones. You need a heavy dumbbell for this. The heavier you can go, the better, because you want to feel it in your obliques here. So the dumbbell is back a little bit. You want your hands in front, legs back. Okay, so the dumbbell is not right underneath you. It's out to the side, but not right where your hands are. Okay, so whichever side the dumbbell is on, you're gonna go down, come up, opposite hand comes underneath, reach under, take it across. That arm goes down, up, reach under, and pull it across. So it's just 12 altogether. It's not 12 on each side. This is one of my favorite core exercises. Next one, two exercises left. So you can do this on a bench if you want. I just did it on the floor because I didn't want to take up too much equipment there. All right, so you're in a glute bridge, squeezing nice and tight. You do a chest fly, drop the glutes down, and squeeze everything up. So down and up, down and up, squeezing everything together. So that one's 12 reps. Last one is core. So you can do your side plank any way you want. If you want to do it up on your hand, you can do it on your hand. If you want to just do it on your forearm, you can do it on your forearm, okay? You can have your feet stacked, have your feet staggered. If you have it like this, there's not a lot of room to move those hips around, but if that's where you can go, then just hold the plank right there. So otherwise, here, hip down, up. I just did mine on my forearm. Okay, if you want to go up on your hands and do them on your hand, then do it that way. But that's 12 each side as well. So that was the Dirty Dozen workout that I did at the last hotel I was at. I will be going to a couple hotels coming up, so more than likely I will have two more workouts for you soon. All right, so I hope you like that workout. You can do it for your classes, you can do it for yourself, do it in the gym. All you need is some dumbbells and a mat. That's it.